Hello all. Today I'm going to explain you about how you can arrange your classes or video conferencing using Zoom. So what we have to do, first of all, you just go to your Gmail Google account and click on Zoom. Just type on Zoom, and when you search it out, then you will find this option. And I'm just explaining you using desktop options. In next video, I'll explain you out how you can do it using mobile app. So we'll click on this Zoom, this one. Then you'll find certain options, and it will ask you to sign up or sign in out. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to sign it out, because I'm not going to sign up using conventional way. Just I'll use this account, yani ki, that means Google account, to sign in. Okay, so when I'll sign in my using my certain Google account, Gmail account, then I'll have several options to start my classes or take my classes. So there are option like upcoming meeting, previous meeting, personal meetings, and this one, meeting templates. Here, when you click on here, you'll find out host meeting, share screen only with video and without video. This is the option, and there are certain settings also. Using settings, you can do many things, but I'm not going to explain you all about this, because you can, after starting meeting also, you can we can do everything. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to start share screen only, like this. Okay, and after, when you click on this, then it will one pop-up window will open, and here you'll click on open Zoom. After, when you click on open Zoom, then it will load first of all, and then it will show you the screen which you wanted to share it out. So for that purpose, I'm going to on certain screen, so that some lecture or something. Yeah, from here, just I am going to open some PPTs, and it will show you as a share screen. So it is opening it out, Zoom, and when it will open, then you will find out option to, like this, see here, I am just going to share the screen. Some cases you can use whiteboard also, you can use only PPTs also, and otherwise several things. So I am just going to use this one, only PPT. When I will click on only PPT share, then it will come to this screen, and here it will start sharing it out. Now the options you will be having, like here, to see manage participants who all have joined. Then you will have one options, mute and unmute all. So when you click on mute all, then here it will show you option allow participant to unmute themselves. Usually what I do, I just check it out, this one, so that they cannot mute by themselves, because there will be some certain noises and disturbance by the student, so that I can click on. When you want to ask the questions, then you can unmute them. After that there are some more options, like mute participants on entry. I mean, whenever they will enter, automatically they will be muted. Allow participants to unmute, and everything is there. Lock meeting, it is the option when you click on lock meeting, no one extra can join this meeting. Then after, one option is there, new share. You can share whiteboard also. When you click on share whiteboard, it will be here, whiteboard. On here, when you click on whiteboard, see, there is an option. I'll show you here. I'll just down it here. See here, before whiteboard, you'll be more in option of more, you'll having chat, invite, record, and all those things. So if you want to record this meeting, whenever you want, you can record. You see, just click on record button, and it will start to ask you join the audio. Joining audio will have two options, join with the computer or test the speaker in Microsoft. So you can join with your computer audio itself, and it will started recording your this one. You can check it out here. You see, it is option, there's two options showing it here, pause recording or stop recording. So whenever you want, you can pause it out, and you can change the screen, and then again you can start your recording. So whatever you will write on this screen, it will be getting recorded, and not only recorded, but it will be showing to your participants also. Okay, but one more thing, that the participant can also write on this. So for that purpose, what you will do, just go again to the more options and disable participant annotation. When you click on disable participant annotation, participant, you only, host can only write on this. Participants will not able to write it out, because some students will use to do something, you know, funny. They will start writing on your screen. So what you do, just go here and here you see that recording will not include video, so it is showing that unmute myself. So no, I'll go here, continue with video, without video only, and then after it will start recording. Now then again I'll come to that share screen here, share screen, and whatever we wanted to share it out, I'll be sharing here. Okay, and then after chat options are there. When you click here, you'll have chat options. Chat, will click on chat, you'll have very several options. When your participants will be here, you can either reply to everyone, or you can reply them privately. There are several options here. Okay, like participants can chat with no one, or host only, or everyone, or like that. So you can control your chatting also from here. Okay, and then after like video, if you want to shoot along with this your video also, so you click on here video, so your webcam will start, and it will starting, you know, start recording your video also. But for that purpose, you need to set it out first. Okay, so I'm just putting it out here. See here, your setting you have to do, and you can record using this one. You just unmute and your voice will started recording. You see that this fluctuation is showing that is getting recorded. Manage participants, I have already explained you out how to manage participants, mute and unmute them all. Okay, then after when you want to take attendance, what I usually do to do, I just use to take the screenshot whomever it is getting connected. Then you can pause your sharing, or you can annotate this one. You can pause your recording, and then again you can change your like slides. Okay, whatever you want to write on your slide, you can write it out. You can, even though you can write the text also, some text you want to check or write it here. You can put several stumps, you can draw circles, many things are there. No issue at all. Okay, and then when you want to again go to the next slide, you can just go click and explain it out. And then if you want to stop the recording and you want to clear it out, just click on here and it will be clear, everything will be clear. When when you want to stop recording, you click here, or resume recording, you click here, or you can say again pause recording or stop recording. When you click on all these buttons, automatically it will stop recording. Okay, and then finally if you want to like stop meeting, end meeting, so you'll click on end meeting. When you'll click on end meeting for all, it will come, and then it will started your whatever record it is getting recorded, it will convert it automatically, and it will convert in the form of what else is getting recorded. I will tell you, it will recorded your video, your audio, as well as your chat also. Everything will be getting recorded, and you can it will make a folder, but it will ask you to save where you want to save it out. So I'll show you. Just see that it is asking where to save. So what I am doing is just clicking on the desktop option, and I am making a new folder, and in this new folder I am just saving this recording. So now it's you see that here it is recorded, because chat is, nothing is there in chat, that's why it is not recorded. Otherwise chat will also be recorded. Click on your zoom option, zoom option. So it will show you that whatever you have done, it is getting recorded here automatically, and that whiteboard screen and everything. Okay, this is the final out. So whatever we have done on this one, it is getting recorded. And okay, initially I'll tell you, initially there was a it was muted, so that's why their voice was not recorded. But afterward when I unmuted, see that voice is also getting recorded. Okay. So this is all, I think, so from my side. For any doubt or any queries, you can ask me, and if you are in trouble. So thank you. That's it for today.